The method of finding missing z-scores can be extended to finding missing x-values, which are referred to as cutoff scores. Let's look at an example below. So let's assume that the average price of a two-bedroom condominium in Pasadena is $540,000, with a standard deviation of $28,000. If a realtor in the area wishes to determine the middle 60% of these two-bedroom condominiums in Pasadena, what are the cutoff scores? Well, we have to first notice that it does say the distribution is normal. So that means we're working with a normal distribution. So I would start off by drawing the normal distribution, setting the mean equal to 540,000, that goes at the center. The standard deviation is 28,000. So next we're going to shade what's called the middle 60%. So the middle 60% tells us we take half of 60%, which is 30%, shade to the left of the mean, 30%, shade to the right of the mean, 30%. That's the middle 60%. And we have what are called two cutoff scores. So the value at this left edge, that's called the left cutoff score, the lower cutoff score. The value at the right edge is called the upper cutoff score. So we're going to have to find these two values using the given area. So to do this, we're going to use the areas. I would always focus on this left area here first, because that's going to be the easier area to determine. And keep in mind, this left tail area is equal to the right tail area. So if we want to find this left tail area, if we focus on one side of the normal distribution, that's equal to 0.5. Okay, so we take 0.5 minus 0.3, that's going to give us 0.2. So this left tail area is equal to 0.2. Keep in mind that the right tail area, since using symmetry, it's also equal to 0.2. And so now what we do is we go back to our table and we look for the area that's closest to 0.2. That's in our table, that's 0.2005. You look to your left and you look up and you find that the corresponding z value will be -0.84. So the z value that corresponds to the left cutoff score is -0.84. By symmetry, the z value that corresponds to the right side should be +0.84. And so now we have our x values and z values coinciding. So the next step is to calculate the two x values. Well, we have what's called the cutoff score formula. It's x equal to mu plus z sigma. So whenever you see the word cutoff, you want to take note and you're going to use this formula. Let's calculate the lower cutoff score formula, the lower cutoff score. So mu is 540,000, the z-score is -0.84, standard deviation is 28,000. Just use the order of operations and we get the lower limit or lower cutoff score to be 516,480. To get the upper cutoff score, we plug in the same values, but now the z-value is +0.84 and we end up with 563,520. So we have our answer, the middle 60% of prices for a two-bedroom condominium in Pasadena falls between 516,480 to 563,520. Okay, and then I have a couple, let's summarize the steps when you need to find a cutoff score. You want to draw and label the normal distribution. You're going to shade in the given area. You're going to use these areas to find the z values and then compute your cutoff scores using the cutoff score formula. Then finalize your results. We have a couple of problems for you to try. We're going to work out number three just to kind of solidify this concept in your minds. So let's say we have a 10K race that's run in Arcadia and the average was 65 minutes for females, with a standard deviation of 12 minutes. find the cutoff score time for a racer to be in the top 3%. Assume the variable is normally distributed. Well, so what we do next is for a top percentage, the area is normally on the right side. So whenever we say a top percentage, it's typically on the right side. But since this is a race, the quicker times are going to usually be the top scores. So the quicker times will be on the left side. So we're going to look for a left percentage, and that's going to be at 0.03. So we want to have this picture in mind when we start the problem. And we have to find our z value. So we need to look for the area closest to 0.03. Well, in our table, the area that's closest to 0.03 is 0.0301 on the negative z value page, because it's going to be a negative z value that we're searching for. That's going to tell us that the negative z value is -1.88. So now we compute our cutoff score. It's x equal to mu plus z sigma. The average was 65 minutes. Z is -1.88. Sigma is 12 minutes. When we do our computations, we get 42.44 minutes. Thus, the cutoff score to be in the top 3% is 42.44 minutes.